to just turn this screen off.
Thank you.
We changed suppliers. It's in aisle 4.
Is it still cruelty free?
Is this the Park Slope Food Co-op or what?
Who's gonna show up?
Gonna show up at the Park Slope Food Co-op.
sign your agreements. You, sir, is there a problem?
No, it's not the problem. Section 2, subsection 8, paragraph 4?
Yeah, I don't see the problem. By becoming a member of the Park Slope Food Co-op, you agree that 98% of all your fruits, vegetables, metal, glass, tin, string, and toilet paper will be recycled within 24 hours.
But isn't it going just a bit too far to have a supermarket dictate my outside behavior?
A supermarket? A supermarket? Yeah, it's very clear you don't belong here, sir. Good day.
Well,
I said good day.
Well.
And I also say good day to you, sir. Yeah. You are exactly the sort of man that we are looking for here at the Park Slope Food Co-op. Now, have I shown you our aisle of organic, unlubricated earthworm skin condoms?
No.
Well, some other time perhaps. Now, visitors, come here. This is the zero emission yak manure burning Gord 3000 freezer. It stores items at a perfect 2 degrees. Yes, I'm talking Celsius, aren't you? It vents off heat to our upstairs head farm where we employ 3 immigrants from Guatemala who receive generous wages and 16 weeks paid vacation. The hemp is used to make ropes for schooners, which harvest line caught fish, which is not only a low-fat protein source for humans, but can be made into bone meal dog biscuits or scaled left abrasion soap. We even recycle the fish eyes for senior citizens with cataracts. Well, Johnny and I of the sanitation committee.
Doris Shankman of the membership committee, we meet again.
Yes. The hemp cloth filter in the freezer needs to be changed, but I can't seem to get the cover off. Can you fix it?
Of course, Doris.
Great. Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but nothing gets inside the Gord 3000 unless it's been grown, harvested, curated, or emitted by a member of the Park Slope Food Co-op. Now, I can give you a private tour some other time, perhaps. But for now, I have to make sure that the meat isn't getting a chill.
I heard they have an entire aisle of tatsoi, escarole, beet grease, chard, and napa cabbage.
Are any of those different from each other?
I don't know. Let's find out.
My mother was a Holocaust survivor, and my dad was in Castro's army. They said I fit in right here. who are you?
I'm Jackie Sojourner Truth Smythe, but the song where the characters introduce themselves ended, so I can't.
Tomorrow! Man, you never know when a hot story is just gonna land right in your freaking lap!
sorry. I didn't think. I saw the freezer was struggling, but I didn't act.
Oh, it's understandable. I mean, it's your first week here. My first week, I put a gumquat into the lychee bin. It's okay, I only got one kind of lychee. Wait a second. Pardon me for the interruption, comrades, but we've had a bit of a spill in aisle one. Can I get a squad leader?
She's on humane treatment break.
It's important.
More important than humane treatment of workers? I can't believe it. After all we sacrificed for the simple, irrefutable benefit of 2 20-minute breaks every hour?
We have a dead body in aisle one. Get the squad leader.
Okay, okay. I'm logging the leftover humane treatment time for our next break.
Yeah, what is it? I was just knitting a kettle cozy for the Team for Tuna fundraiser.
Thank God you're here.
Thank who?
Just a figure of speech. I'm really glad you're here. We need to call the cops.
Call the cops? Not without a vote.
You're right, we must convene the committee. Attention, all members of the Public Safety and Composting Committee, please meet at the head of aisle one. The murderer might still be here. Hey, Jerry, how's it going?
Wow, just chilling. Get it? I was in the freezer. What's with Doris?
She's dead.
Is she getting shift credit for this? Because if she is, I know a lot of people who are going to try this scam. I'm on work alert because I missed my last shift to go to the Make Spores Not Wars Festival. I just love bear tree mushrooms and rogue peas in that order.
Okay, let's call this meeting to order. I'm deputizing all visitors as official co-op members since you are the prime witnesses.
Can we vote?
Vote? We have to observe Robert's rule of order. We can't vote until someone makes a motion.
Makes a motion without a translator?
I know that. I'll be the translator.
I make a motion to call the cops and investigate the apparent murder.
Do I have a second?
Point of information?
Yes, Muffy Goldmayer Finkelberg.
What language are you signing?
American Sign Language, of course. What do you mean? Of course. I believe co-op bylaws strictly call for a Native American Sign Language translator. Where is the NASL translator?
I know nasal. I can translate.
Okay, so do I have a second?
Point of information?
Second, does that mean I approve of the motion or merely that I'm in favor of vigorous debate, which is the foundation of our Western style and therefore racist democracy? Racist democracy only. You don't have to support any measure to call out state security experts to investigate the apparent murder.
Good. I hate to take a position before hearing a lengthy and an entirely unnecessary debate.
I can't believe you signed that.
But she's starting to love you. Congestion.
Now you know what.
Okay. The measure's on the floor. Jerry, do you wish to speak on behalf of your motion?
Ah, thank you. Respected comrades, a great crime has been committed.
Point of information? Allegedly.
Yes, allegedly committed inside our hallowed halls. Doris, our beloved founder, has been murdered.
Point of information? Allegedly?
Just allegedly murdered inside this co-op. We need to call the police and investigate.
Allegedly.
I cede the floor.
Okay, speeches are limited to 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Yes, sure, tomorrow.
Many years ago, I was organizing workers on a left-wing vineyard outside Barstow. We were seeking dignity, fair wages, vacation time, and government-subsidized kale. The sun was hot, the hours long, the kale grotesque. But there was a man there who never stopped doing his job, no matter how many times the landowners beat him. So, as you can see, broken windows policing just doesn't work.
All those in favor of calling the police to investigate the apparent murder, say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed to calling the police to investigate the apparent murder, say nay.
Nay.
Both the ayes have it. Let's call the police. One more thing. Don't move that body.
But she's mocking Nicole Rodney!
Yeah, that's the stuff. Yeah, deeper. Deeper, deeper. Detective Dick Johnson here? Oh. The Park Slope Food Co-op, huh? What happened? Did someone mix up the organic papayas with the normal ones? Did someone walk out in a huff because someone else suggested that Israel was a rogue state? Murder, huh? Human or produce? Doris, huh? I'll be right over. Doris Chiang Kai-shekman. Just when I thought I had pulled out, you pull me back in.
Excuse me, but does anyone know if we sell Drano?
Drano? Drano is a toxic chemical. We do sell an alternative called earthworm. It's actually just earthworms.
It's horrible what happened to Doris, but can we get around to moving the body? Why? Can you not reach the handmade hipster salami?
Excuse me, sir, can I please see your membership card?
Oh, that's so aggressive!
Listen, punk, I shit bigger than you.
Well, maybe if you ate more produce, your excrement would not only be manageable in size, but it could give off a floral scent.
Thank you for coming. What is that in your hand?
Oh, this, look, I...
It's a celebration! I don't want to be here!
Disgusting!
It's yerba mate.
It tastes like boiled grass.
It's sustainably harvested boiled grass.
You people really make me sick. The least you can do is get me one of those lemon spritzers you sell. I had one the last time you morons called me in.
Oh no. We stopped carrying those last year after we found out it was manufactured in the West Bank.
So what? They were delicious.
Of course, we organized a boycott so Israel could not profit from its occupation. And the fact we was out of business.
Mission accomplished. Yes.
And dozens of Palestinians lost their livelihoods, so.
Well, the call-off has to stand for something, so.
Yes, you're supposed to stand for supporting workers who would have been better off if you kept selling those Israeli spritzers.
Of course you think that. You're a conservative pig.
Well, perhaps you wouldn't say that if I expressed it in a more crowd-pleasing manner. I hear you're the kind of fellow who picks up a pomelo and doesn't just see it tasty for root. You're worried about the country that raised this little munchie and afraid that you'll support it with your loot. Well, I'm here to let you know that everywhere you go, there's someone doing something wrong. The world's a mess, and if you never ate food from a guilty state, you'd satisfy your conscience while you starve to death. Cause sometimes a melon's just a melon. Sometimes a peanut's nothing more than a legume that you consume after the shelling. Regardless, it is farmers, we're at war. Take this bottle of Corona, if it came from Barcelona, would you roll your eyes complaining about Spain? Sure, I could take the hard position that the land of the Inquisition should never be supported. Inside this bar, or from a tree inside Qatar, where workers build in stadiums for football, were treated very badly, and many died so sadly, but thousands died for the Brooklyn Bridge, and you don't care at all, cause sometimes a belly's just belly.
100% organic.
Great.
But it is still the blood of a butchered animal that we do consume for protein.
This guy is going to be one tough suspect to crack. You there! Tell me everything you know about the victim.
Doris? Everyone loved Doris.
No one loved Doris.
True. No one loved Doris. I remember when I first met her. My wife and I had just moved to Brooklyn, where we were lucky enough to snag the last two-bedroom apartment for $5,000. I was so excited to join the co-op. I did the blood test, I signed the paperwork, I took a loyalty oath, and I even went to orientation. But then I was called into the office.
Shmuel Guevara, thank you for coming.
Sure.
So, you're the new tenant at 342 Berkeley.
Yep.
Did your wife join the co-op too? And your kids?
My wife. My kids.
How did I know you were married on June 8th? How did I know that you joined the co-op the very next day, and your wife and two adopted children haven't? Have they?
No! No, I did it! In fact, she's a Costco right now!
We knew it. You're just like everyone else, with only one official shift working member of the co-op while the whole family benefits. How is the co-op supposed to work without everyone doing his or her share, huh? This household is officially on work alert.
What?
Costco, huh? You people think the kumquats magically fall into the kumquat bin. While you're sitting in your brownstone talking politics, drinking your gin, lights on the ceiling are powered by the gas that comes out of each can eating member's ass. But it takes work and drive to keep the co-op alive. If you want a piece of this pie, you better sign up for free shifts a week till the day that you die. You gotta work for your
baseball
games or whatever.
Really? Seriously? Anything? thing.
I'll tell you what, your whole family can stay.
Thanks, Doris, I really appreciate it.
But you'll say what I tell you to, mm-hmm. and you'll do what I say.
Yes, ma'am.
Because my letter detector is ringing off the
just holds your clothes, but here
Vitamin?
Oh, yes! It's just 420 a pill.
Oh, great. Oh, wow! That really great a bigger race of soul! Woo! Lost my shoe! Ha ha! Yeah!
So you resented Doris for making
yourself... Easy, Smythe! I'm the detective here. So you resented Doris for making you sell supplements. You're now my prime suspect, Windchime. But wait a second. Who was that other guy in that weird flashback just now?
I believe you're referring to me. Johnny and I?
And I, babe. Who the hell are you?
Don't worry, comrade. I am not throwing away your snout.
Oh, Johnny, is there nothing or no one you won't do?
Comrade, I don't want to brag, but, yeah. Chicken coop in my backyard. I deliberately myself I work with a doula, here's a car. I recycle my own children's room. And I do double shifts all the time right here at the co-op. I'm nature's man. I got a 3-year plan to rid this world of bottles and papers and soda cans. So shampoo your hair, change your underwear. That way you can be nature's man.
He's nature's man. He's nature's man.
I bike to work. I bike to the store. Sometimes I drag it on the subway. I never hold up to close the door. My house in Carroll Garden. That I think marriage should only be legal for gays. My comment for real, it don't leave trace. I love whites, I love blacks, I love Palatino. I'm guessing the one third Native American crowd. Maybe that's some Uzbeki blood. There's some totally blind to red.
He's a nature's man, he's wingless friend. The world is free of bottles and paper and soda cans.
So it's around.
Hmm.
boycott Israeli products? And what's this? A lipstick kiss? I know that color, too. It's Burt Bee's Magenta Rush. But who? Who in this co-op wears that particular environmentally sound yet extremely sexy color? It's you! Who are you?
I am Muffy Goldemeyer Finkelberg, and I may prefer the socially conscious look of a no animal testing cosmetic, but I'm certain that I have nothing to do with this, no matter who I've been making out with.
Making out? What does that have to do with Doris's death?
You're the cop here, Johnson. All I know is that Doris didn't like everyone that I liked. It seems like only yesterday.
Is that frise from the Golan? A land stolen from my people. How could you?
I've never hated a vegetable more. Curse you, divisive frise.
My people hate your people, and your people hate mine.
We should be fighting over walls and steeples left from ancient times.
Your ancestors kicked mine out. One day they're the next day gone.
If not, I'll write you both up.
This isn't about safe sex, Doris. And you know it. It's about the situation in the Middle East. It's about a people yearning to till the soil of their fathers without the yoke of an oppressive regime.
No, it's about the condom. So just toss it in the bin in the Gore 3000 when you're done, please. Thanks. This is ridiculous. They will never accept us. There will always be some freeze-dried lettuce or loofah or Doris Shankman to tear us apart. I'm sorry, Ellie.
No, Muffy. There's got to be a way. She only wants us to practice environmentally safe sex. Then come back. In this frozen box of steel, time is frozen too, but it's not real. They will never make me feel.
Thank you.
spew, but bicycles will kill you too.
Satisfied Doris better than a plate of organic bok choy. soy sprinkled with fair trade tamari. But you've got no proof, Radicchio.
And I've got all the proof that I need. I don't know, maybe perhaps this little something right here means something to him.
Actually, no it doesn't. You're holding it way too close to my face.
Right, well, this is a Park Slope Food Co-op memorandum, a medical exposition. And you know what's in it, don't you?
Doris told the co-op directors that she was sleeping with me. And that she was pregnant with my child?
Yes, but you couldn't let her tell anyone, could you? You'd be stripped of your badge. So you killed her, didn't you? Didn't you? It's classic. Organic activists like Doris are just expendable to you corporate stooges. Well, usually you can just chew them up and spit them out like the T-bone steaks that are destroying the earth. That is not a metaphor, that is the truth. Murderer!
Wait a
Johnson, you have the right to remain silent. And if you cannot afford an attorney, a squad leader will be appointed to you to make sure that you're in right. Case closed, comrades, case closed.
Wait a second, and I'm, you're in the right church, but the wrong pew.
Oh, no, I'm a Buddhist. We mostly just sit on mats. It's very uncomfortable.
What I'm trying to say is that you don't know the full story. Like most men I know, your climax was premature. I couldn't find the wine that Doris was looking for, so I went back downstairs. I love you, Dick. And I've loved you since the moment I laid eyes on you. And so- that shipment of Colombian-shaped grown coffee.
I've already told you it'll never work out. You're a left-wing idealist, and I'm a conservative, hawkish red skater who literally totes around a gun for a living. We have about as good chance of being together as Rachel Maddow, Clarence Thomas, and Kim Kardashian having a freeway.
This time, it'll be different.
Why? You'll accept me for who I am?
Accept you? No, no, I'm going to change you. They say a Republican's just a Democrat who got mugged. I say a Democrat's a Republican who got hugged. Yes, sometimes a war is racist, all you need to make that cold, cold heart yours to lead. Secretly, I know what you wanna be. So stay with me and you will see. Dangers and fiddleheads will make page one, I'm sure.
Johnson? What are you doing here, Detective? I thought you were going to the racial profiling skills class.
Come on, Smythe. Everybody knows the racial profiling skills class is the oldest trick in the book. We all know cops don't need a class for that. Anyway, I figured if I came back at 3 in the morning, and all was around, I could get some real investigating done around here. Smiley, there must be something in the Gore 3000 that will help me break this case open.
And he gets a big story. All I see is a lot of conflict-averse summer squash and... Oh, this case of frozen semen.
Frozen semen? Look at this. Johnny Endive, Ali Al-Muhammad, Jerry, Sergeant Dick Johnson. But Doris knew I was shooting blanks.
What a load.
I know. I may not have the scenes, but I've got the watering can.
What a load of crap. If Doris knew you were sterile, why would she save your semen?
Well, she was insane about recycling. My guess is that the murderer put it here. Right next to this red herring!
I think we need to get some real light in here. Oh, this looks like a light.
No! No! Never flip an unidentified switch in the crucial moment of an investigation! Trapdoor gave it away, huh? And look at this.
To serve by a name.
It's a cookbook.
So what if it is? It's people? What if it is people? Oh, no!
Oh, are you an idiot? Wait a minute, it's not people. Look around. Maybe we can find out who's working in this clandestine plant. Jerry! What's going on down here? And what are you putting in Vitaman?
You're the cop, Johnson. All I know is that it flies off the shelf, makes people feel mellow, and we stock it next to the kale chips because people tend to buy them at the same time.
Well, that sounds like a great product. What's in it? Kiko Biloba? St. John's work.
Oh my God, Spice, can't you see where it's made of? Why do you think it's selling so fast?
Because it's healthy.
It's pot. And we're on the ground floor.
Wait, aren't we in the basement?
You're once again my prime suspect, Jerry. Your Vitaman made people feel good.
But you got greedy, right? And you killed Doris just as she was about to infiltrate your little ring.
You're wrong, Johnson. Putting pot in Vitaman was Doris's idea. She finally found an organic product that could bring in some real cash.
Phil! I knew it! Wing chime!
Why would you all go and turn our co-op into a drug factory? Isn't the co-op supposed to be keeping us healthy with fresh organic tempeh and tofu spice rubs?
But weed is healthy, man.
Some people swear that they just can't eat anything sweet or anything meat. And these days it seems that everyone dreams of a world that's free of wheat. Some say a regime of enemas made of king cobra venom is the one thing they need. Get through their day. Well, some swear by swimming, jogging, or spinning. None of that makes me feel okay. Only one thing I know helps me get up and go, and into my step puts a bound. Well, it's lightweight and clean, and it's natural and green. It comes by the ounce.
2, 3, 4!
Pop, I take a hit, it hits the spot. No need to drink or take a shot. I feel like flying like an astronaut into space in a haze of cotton. In a good old days, I'd fight about the blaze with a bad and dangerous bad. Anybody had a job in a smoke and no job and she went and asked so bad. But nowadays, there's so many ways to get a little high. But I raised up a little sense of fresh pop, it's hard purple apple pie. You can crave this aroma, just say you back.
Investigating the death?
No, I mean, where was I? I don't remember anything about last night.
You're welcome.
In any event, it is time to unmask the murderer. Clearly, all of you wanted Doris dead. Let's take the roll. First, we've got the guy who was so upset that he was put on work alert his very first day.
Here, detective.
Then I've got the long-suffering squad leader, forced to hawk vitamins.
Yep, I'm here.
Then we've got the hot Jewess.
That's smoking hot Jewess, and yes, I'm here.
Who wanted Doris dead because she disapproved of your relationship?
No, I wanted her dead because I hated those condoms. It was like fucking an alligator through three layers of saran wrap.
And I see her secret Arab lover is here.
Yes, I do. I do not recognize any legitimacy of an inquest of any usurper, of course.
I have pot dealing little Jerry.
Here, sir.
I already have you on drug charges. But there's more! You're nothing without this co-op. You're a geek, you dress funny, and you don't fit in anywhere else except this organic freak show. And Doris knew exactly how to play you. And you couldn't stand that she made you sell your soul for a quick buck. And you sent her to that great hemp field in the sky.
I read in Gizmodo that geeks are hot right now.
And then, of course, we have Johnny Endive, the Elvis Presley of the Park Slope Food Coop.
Thank you very much.
A man who was so jealous of how completely and utterly I satisfied Doris that he, you, would go even lower than the sewage system that he, you, vowed to uphold, all the way down to falsifying a pregnancy report and committing murder.
Nice try, detective. But for the first time since I joined the sanitation committee, I'm clean. I may have fabricated that report, but that's only because everybody knew I was in the Gore 3000 with Doris the day that she died. But I did not kill her. You did. Well, add yourself to the attendance list, Detective Dick Johnson.
Sir, we have Detective Dick Johnson, whose professional impropriety is certainly grounds for murder.
So is that everyone?
No! I also have Jackie Sojourner Truth Smythe, perhaps the woman with the greatest motive for murder of us all.
What could possibly have been my motive? I'm not a murderer, I'm just a journalist.
Exactly. And you were about to break the story of Doris's secret sperm stash. That means you knew long ago that she was breeding a race of cult members who would infiltrate our society and transform the entire food system into a left-wing experiment.
I don't believe what's happening here because I have no idea. But that is a great story! I didn't even know the marijuana subplot from before.
Don't play dumb with me, Smythe. You knew! And that's exactly why you led me straight to that tray in the Gore 3000.
Have you read my articles? The biggest story I ever wrote was the time that I wrote about how 70% of all people who use the express line had more than 12 items. There really wasn't much reporting to do there. I basically just stood there. Why are you fingering me, Dick? I was going to clear you with that sex scene with you and Doris.
That's the oldest trick of the book, Smythe. The dame with a torch trying to mess with the hunky cop's head. It's a classic! Except I'm no patsy. And you're not nearly as hot as the woman is supposed to be if such scenarios are going to work as a dramatic device. But Doris was onto you. And she was about to report you to the membership committee.
She was?
Absolutely. That's the theory I'm working on. Yeah.
Look, I don't care if you want to frame me for murder, but please don't tell the membership committee.
And that leaves only one suspect. Ali Ali Al-Akh Muhammad.
Ali Al-Muhammad.
You're just racial profiling, and we don't do that here.
But I found a Quran in his locker.
So what? It's a sacred book. Even Thomas Jefferson had it. You're misinterpreting it.
But I found these airline receipts of a trip he once took to Yemen And this satellite photo that reveals him at an Al-Qaeda training ground.
That's a satellite photo of me playing in the 2012 Gamal Al Nasser Arabian Youth Soccer Tournament. Oh, look, you can see the gold there and everything.
Well then.
Oh, dear me.
What is this? What is this? See? It's a bomb!
It's a clock! I'm making brownies in the test kitchen upstairs. Well, we'll be ready in 12 minutes.
This is ridiculous, Detective. I think it's time that we start considering someone from the outside.
From the outside, eh? Like some new piece of information is just going to dramatically walk through that door and solve this whole case.
Wait, you can't come in here with a dog.
How dare you? This is my comfort animal, Trotsky. And I have all the paperwork from the Mental Health and Crystals Committee. He's very well behaved. What is it? You smell something, boy?
That's exactly where Doris' body was lying.
But I haven't seen Trotsky behave this way since...
Since when?
Since I was at Griswold's non-organic, inhumane, pesticide-filled factory farm, and we were in the fields watching them spray the strawberries with chemicals!
Chemicals, huh?
This makes perfect sense. Remember when I was in the produce aisle with a Buffy Goldemeyer Fingerberg fooling around that time?
How can I forget?
Oh, me too. My forbidden Jewish lover was pillowy lips and goblet-like bosoms are like the fertile plains of Mesopotamia.
Oh, but that's not what I'm talking about.
Oh, remember those grapes? You spit them out and said they tasted like they came from a bodega.
Oh, that's ridiculous! The co-op only buys organic. Nothing has any kind of toxins. Never, huh? Then how do you explain that a woman was lying there, dead, from an overdose of pesticides?
Hold the hearse, Smythe. That's all so clear to me now. That is not conventional pesticide. That's methylparathion. You see, I grew up on a farm. Not one of your hipster agriculture museums, but a real working farm. My dad used methylparathion all the time to sedate the animals. Oh, Daddy, I forgive you for breaking my heart. I know you did the best you could. Never mind! Smelling salts won't work. Have to try something bigger.
Oh.
Adrenaline! Smythe, what's plan C?
Attention all co-op members. Someone forgot to pay the 5-cent fee for taking a plastic bag. Who didn't pay for his plastic bag?
Doris, you see everyone. Methylparathion can make an animal appear completely dead, even when it's still alive. And well, that is exactly what's happened here.
Yes. Yes, and I have the strangest dream. You were there. And you were there, and you were denying the importance of biodiversity. And you were convinced you shouldn't be on work alert because you did your makeup shift on time. And you were there too. And you, I saw you using an aerosol deodorant. And you, I saw you shopping at Whole Foods. And you, Shmuel Gavada, I saw you eating a hot dog.
Oh.
And you, Johnson, I saw you completely naked, glistening in the full moon of a clear summer night, wanting me desperately, but unable to get an erection.
Relax, everyone. Dreams are never real, never.
You are so horrible. How can you bring evil pesticides into our co-op? You freaks think we can run a business selling organic produce at below market prices because all of the members do all of the labor? Yeah, and you think we can do this and still offer staff generous wages and health benefits and 6 weeks vacation and free bike repairs? That's a Soviet progressive dreamland, people! I started making up our losses by selling our weed vitamins, but it wasn't enough. No, so I partnered with Griswold's non-organic, inhumane, pesticide-filled factory farm to get some cut-rate crap in this place so I could finally start making a profit! A profit? How gross would live in a world where Jews and Arabs can live side by side in the same country. But at the rate you two are going, there'd be no untainted tatsoi left. Besides, even Jimmy Carter says that the two-state solution is the only one that works.
I'm a liberal, and if I keep listening to this talk, I might have to reconsider my worldview.
You know what, Doris? My love for Ali is greater than my commitment to any nation state. I think I finally realize that now. Sorry, Ali, can you forgive me for leaving you?
Oh, of course, darling. Sorry, get the loop up.
Wait, what about the little sperm bank we're keeping in the door 3000, Doris? I mean, surely you were collecting the DNA of all the most virile, the most intelligent, the most socially active members of the co-op so that you could breed a race of super liberals. Right?
No, sweet sugar man of the garbage. No. I'm selling your sperm to the Republican National Committee, who's experimenting to see if progressive values can be identified and genetically eliminated.
Can you blow her up? You must be able to turn that kitchen timer into a bomb.
No!
What? Don't you think you've learned a few things over the past years?
No!
Wait. There's still one thing I don't understand. Why did you keep my seedless man juice in the Gore 3000?
Do you know how many guys have tried to pull the old "we don't need to use a condom, babe, sterile" trick on me? You think I was born yesterday? No. The last thing I could afford was to get pregnant. Given my belief that life begins before conception.
I can't believe we were sad when we thought you were dead.
We can't have these kind of ad lorem hymns in the co-op. We wanted her dead before. Let's finish the job!
Yes!
This is for treating me like a piece of meat. You just wanted me for my shift.
This is for never giving me a sit down interview for the weekly composter. This is for making me a corporate shill.
This is for making Trotsky feel uncomfortable.
Not another you got.
This is for... What's this for?
For turning you into a pot dealer and exploiting your liberal pipes.
What he said.
This is for denying me the right to live freely.
In the produce aisle. All of the brownies are done.
This is for not using only my semen in your eugenics experiment. You people are putting me in quite a pickle. What?
No.
If you guys still believe in police brutality, the people have spoken!
Hey, two. Johnson. Ben Paul Shankman.
Big, weak hands, man.
My place is a campus yurt with no running water or air conditioning.
I guess it will be mine.